I'm sure your memory recall capability is very good and you would have come up with the right answers for all of these entries. Let me just quickly summarize what I'm sure that most of you have gotten already. In all cases except this, where the global part of the faulting node P's cache is empty, the local part, of course, is going to go up by 1. The global part is going to come down by 1. Only when the global part is empty already, there is no change. And in both cases, there's no change to the balance between L and G on both the node Q, which is supplying the page X, and the node R that happens to have the LRU page, because it is not even part of the action in terms of the page fault handling for these two cases. Now, the third case is where it is on the disk, and therefore this is immaterial, right? Because it's not in any cluster memory right now. It is on the disk, so it's not applicable. So the question is, what happens to the guy that has the globally oldest page? If it is on the disk and we have to bring it into the faulting node, then necessarily we have to make space in the cluster memory as a whole for this extra page. So because this guy's balance is going to shift and I have to throw this global page somewhere, I'm picking this guy as a replacement candidate because he has the globally oldest page. But what is going to happen on this node? Well, it really depends on whether the LRU page comes from the global part or the local part. If it comes from the global part, then there is no change on R because you're basically throwing this into the global part and he's throwing one of those global pages out onto the disk, right? If, on the other hand, the global page that I sent over here results in replacing a local page on node R because the local page happens to be the LRU candidate, then L goes down by 1 and G goes up by 1. So we are able to do more community service in this case. And in the last case, when it is actively shared, again, even though we find the missing page in node Q, there's no change in the balance of L and G because it is coming from the active part of L because it is shared. It indicates if it is shared, it has to be from the L part of Q. Since it is actively shared, there's no change in the split between L and G. And of course, this guy has to send one of its global pages to some other node because the memory pressure as a whole is increasing on node P. This guy is going to send it to node R that has the LRU page. And just like in this case where I have to make room for the cumulative memory pressure on the cluster by throwing out a page onto the disk, and similar to this case, if the candidate replacement page comes from the local part of R, then it is going to result in the local part shrinking by 1 and the global part increasing by 1 to accommodate the page that came from here.